FTW Broadcasting here for the win. We bring you hot StarCraft II action. Thank you so much for tuning in, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you so much to Force Strategy Gaming for hosting this Trollcast on his channel. If you're not familiar with Trollcasts, they're basically about extreme noobage and epic tactics. Yes, anybody who's doing crazy things that are out of the ordinary, we like to cast them in these Trollcasts. So let's dive right into it. We got a 2v2 here, and my pick is going to be the top left-hand team. My name's AWOL, and joining me, as always, is my boy Danny. He's got the bottom right team, Jay Meester, playing as the red Protoss.
And I'm going to interrupt you right there just because Jay Meester has just announced to the entire game that he will rape you all.
Wow.
Great. So...
My wife does not like the term rape being used so loosely in video games. She told me that the other day. Do you feel like she's being a prude?
No, I think she's correct, but I think she's a prude for other reasons.
Hey, you better watch it, buddy. This is on the internet. Okay, Jay Meester playing his red Protoss. Back to business. Blue Zerg playing up here in the top left-hand corner. That's Bones. And I'll let you introduce your own team, Danny.
Sure, my team down here, Shiva, the purple Terran, and Ares Drake, the teal Terran. You know, double Terran, the superior race. Nah, mass ravens. That's what I like to hear. Are we going to see mass ravens from Shiva? Is she just teasing me?
Maybe she is just teasing you. I don't know. Haha, good point. Never knew. All right, so I wonder where these kids are from. I always wonder. I wish there was like a little flag icon in StarCraft where you could see what country other players are from. But, of course, it's on Battle.net, so that could spur like racial slurs and further hatred.
It's
so
true.
It could end up being a bad thing.
Well, they were talking about their high school finals a little earlier in the chat box, and they do speak relatively good English. I'm going to assume that they are American, perhaps Canadian. I don't think it really matters either way, though.
Yeah, it probably doesn't matter. That's true. America and Canada are so similar. Americans, for some reason, they have something about Canadians. They like to make fun of Canadians. Well, what's up with that?
I don't know. Why would anyone make fun of Canadians, eh?
Put some KD, eh?
They seem like a good people. That's what it's. I don't know what that's all about.
But I'll tell you what it's about. All right, I'm going to get back to the game here briefly, Danny. All right, Bones up in the top left-hand corner. Dropped down his spawning pool pretty late. I mean, he has 15 pool. He did send out an Overlord Scout. And Jay Meester is got a Cyber Core as well as a Gateway. No doubt that first unit is going to be a Stalker. He has only single gas right now, and he's got too many probes mining gas. That is an interesting thing to note. Of course, that is part of the extreme noobage. Danny, what's your team doing here? How about Ares Drake? What do you think is in his future?
Oh, let's see. He's got a Rax, another Rax. Looks like we're going to be Heavy Marine, Marauder. He's got a Marauder coming out, a couple Marines here. Perhaps this is a simple MMM push, nothing fancy. Looking up at Shiva, we see the barracks, we see the factory. So he is moving his way towards that Mass Ravens he promised us. And I swear, if he didn't promise us, if he doesn't deliver on that promise, I will cry. And by cry, I mean something more manly than cry.
what do you mean then? That confuses me.
Hey, I don't have to tell you, just because you don't know what it is, and you're not manly enough to know.
Oh, okay. Have I ever seen it in the movies? Hey, Bones got a sneaky expansion here in the top right-hand corner. It's up and running. I don't know if that'll be scouted anytime soon, so that's probably a good spot. That's not the logical natural for him.
No, definitely not. Shiva's got his starport going as he asks his ally, what strat do you want? And he says, simple, I guess. You know, the good old KISS method. It's always a popular method. We'll see. He says, ha-ha, okay. I like the look of that ha-ha. It looks like a ha-ha, I'm going to build a million ravens.
Yes. Hopefully he does build a million ravens. They scouted. Okay, so these kids don't look too bad. They actually spotted that overlord in the back of his base. There are some idle SCVs going on here, but... it looks like this is going to be scouted immediately. This Overlord is in such an opportune position, going to see that tech lab being dropped down on that starport. He's only to suspect.
Yeah, and you could call them idle SCVs, and I call them that they're just union.
They're union. They're on break.
Yeah, they're on break.
Well, if they were truly union, Danny, then there would be two SCVs building any building at any given time, because they can't do the job by themselves because it is unsafe and they would call OSHA.
I don't know what that is. You clearly have actual interaction with unions.
I do have interaction with unions, and I'm pro-union, for the record, Internet, pro-union. We have a whole bunch of workers transferring over here to this expansion for Bones. They are going to be just fine. There's no opposition right now. Jay Meister also expanding. So all four players on the map do have their expansions heading up and running right now. So it looks like we are going to have somewhat of a mid-game in this replay. So that's exciting. We'll get to see some epic battles, I hope.
That is nice. And nobody's messing with each other. I guess maybe they called, 10 minutes no rush before the game started.
Maybe they did. They did. They did. All mid AREM. Look at this Seeker Missile upgrade being researched right now. Seeker Missiles, Danny, that's something we haven't seen in any of our casts. We haven't seen effective Seeker Missile usage, and it can be very devastating if you micro-orbit correctly. It is hard to effectively use Seeker Missiles against a good player, though.
Well, absolutely. Good thing we're in a troll cast.
Yes, which is very promising. And I'd like to see more scouting. You know, somebody commented that I'd like to see more scouting this game. But I really would. I mean, look at that giant black fog of war area in the center of the map. Nobody's even thought about just passing by those Zelnaga towers.
Just give them a little peek, a little tap.
Yeah, it's a nice area over there. I mean, it's like a public park. There's a little mist and stuff to keep you cool. I don't know what I'm talking about. Three gates are up and running here from Jay Meister, and he's pumping out. Looks like he's going Mass Stalker this game. No Twilight Council yet, though, so there isn't any Blink upgrades.
No, and that's unfortunate for this one stalker here who is blocked in.
Thank you. I set you up for that one. Extreme noobage. Good job, buddy. Well, he's going to be able to defend those three gateways from the ledge there if anything tries to scan.
That's true. It's true. He's an anti-drop stalker.
He's the most brave of all the stalkers.
Sure. Well, that's what he writes back to his wife and kids. Sakani, I defended a corner of our base.
Oh, honey, you're so brave. He's going to get a big kiss to his mechanical lips since he's been resurrected. No. This premise is just falling apart as I am.
I don't know. I assume that she's just banging the immortal next door.
Why wouldn't you, though, with those big arm muscles?
I know.
Man. That bonus damage to armored? Give it to me.
I see what you did there with the bonus gift. That is gross.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Speedlings from Bones hanging out on this ramp. He's got a massive amount of speedlings pulling up that units tab. And he's looking at how many here? 42 already. And speaking of units tab, my team right now has the economic advantage. They have far more workers at this point, and they're going to be pulling in a lot more cash. And they should go ahead and attack now.
Yeah, I don't know if I'd call that far more, especially against a Terran who can use mules. But in the end, looks like Ares Drake has a fairly decent MM army here. He needs to get a couple medevacs up there to really spice it up. But he's finally going to start moving through that middle park area. He's got to break it down. Looks like it was condemned by the city, so that's probably why they weren't coming through. You see all this garbage in the way.
Oh, maybe that was from the renovation.
Yeah, it's true. Who knows? I think they were going to turn it into a skate park. Maybe a dog park. Who knows?
Yeah.
We'll see.
If we were playing Tony Hawk right now, you could probably get a nice little grind bonus on the side of the ramps there. Grind your way up.
Yeah, but nobody plays Tony Hawk anymore.
They don't?
Not since the most recent debacle, is my understanding.
Oh, I'm not up to date with that. I haven't kept up with Tony Hawk since N64.
Oh, yeah, it was awesome then. We are talking about Tony Hawk. You guys should fight or something.
Fight. Please fight. All right, Shiva has the Ravens up and running at the front of this base, though, and it looks like Shiva really is going to hold off for the mass Ravens, which, you know, is a really good idea. I would like to see Shiva pump out a couple extra Vikings. He could run around the map and pick off some Overlords, which he knows are out there, but I guess he doesn't want to do that. He just wants the Ravens. Stick with the plan.
Stick with the plan.
They said keep it simple already. Why am I not? I guess I didn't get the memo.
Yeah, that's right. He's got that armor upgrade for his Ravens. More Ravens on their way. I mean, looks like he's got a couple Marines to spice things up. He's even giving them the shields. See? It's truly a pro's pro.
Oh. Check out this. This must be Jay Meister. Must be a StarCraft 1 player. Check out the pylon placement along the edge here. This is reminiscent of the old StarCraft 1 strategy. Put a million pylons around the edges of your base, and then put a cannon in between each one to defend. I used to see that a lot in StarCraft 1, so maybe this kid, maybe he's not actually a kid, maybe he's an adult.
Yeah, I don't know. You definitely see that on the old big game hunters maps. Yeah. You know, any of those long free for all maps, you just hold where you basically you just hold up and you know, get some decent defenses so no one messes with you, and then mass carriers and win.
That's exactly right. And mass carriers, everybody gets mass carriers because that's the only thing that can take down like 40 cannons along the edge of your entire base. Those games are fun though. You set up for like 45 minutes before you move in. It's like, yeah, I'm gonna win. Oh no, he attacked me with carriers first. No, good game. Good game. But that meant you were good at the game, right?
That was my understanding. And then you just, you know, try again.
See, whatever. We were 13.
Yeah, the robotics bay is now down. Looks like maybe we might be seeing a Colossus coming up for, or J-Meister, too, to back up those Stalkers. I thought I like that. The Stalkers are kind of like baby Colossi.
Where do you get that assumption? Why? Because they both have giant heads?
They have the same shape.
They do kind of have the same shape.
Try to imagine like a giant Colossus just giving birth to the Stalkers.
Is there like gooey liquid?
Oh, you! Oh, it's so gross.
What's the sound like? Is it like?
It's like that, but more robotic.
Okay. Okay.
You should
maybe
work
you can
on.
Put on one of your Logitech like robotic sound effects. You could do that for us sometime. Or maybe one of our fans can go ahead and put up. Why would anybody want to see that? I'm kind of intrigued at this point, though.
I am too. We're about to have a knockdown drag out brawl right here, though.
Yes, we are. Right now, I'm at 1602. Let me know if we're in the same spot right now. Marines are starting to get involved with these Stalkers, and we got a big altercation, but this massive Zerglings is going to come in here and clean up shop. This expansion is pretty much doomed at this point. Where are those Ravens?
Yeah, they're coming in right now. We go just a second too late or so. Let's see what they're going to do. Are they going to drop are they going to drop turrets or anything? No, they're going to just kind of fly around. Okay. Nice Raven play.
Oh my god, this is the worst micro ever. I mean, they just dropped down two turrets. Any seeker missiles? Oh, boom! A couple seeker missiles there. That was very effective. If they would have dropped those earlier when everything was bunched up, they would have gotten even more casualties. Yeah. There was a number of kills there. A couple of these Ravens are corporals.
Yeah, there was a... Okay, there. They lured them into these siege tanks too as well, so that was okay, but... Whew. Just okay. Try again.
Hey, at least we got some action now, Danny. We don't have to BS for a while. Amuta coming in here, trying to take on 3 Thors and 18 Marines by himself. He... was trying to be like a boss. That didn't work out, though.
It rarely does. He was trying to keep it real, and it went wrong. As a wise man once said, if you can't keep it real, it's just going to go wrong.
It does. It does. I don't like people playing on my phone. That's all I remember. And Blue is streaming in tons of reinforcement units here. It's a good old-fashioned Muta Zergling mix, and this thing's going to work out. By the way, nice upgrades on both. He's got 1-1 on the air and the ground. I like that. There are a number of missile turrets and a planetary fortress up and running at Ares Drake's natural expansion.
Oh, here comes the seeker missile. Boom! Right into the Colossi, which, you know, is fine. The Zerglings come streaming in, are just getting ripped up by those Thors and Marines and siege tanks. I don't know what that was. That was Zap Brannigan-esque play with those Zerglings.
Send wave after wave of my own men. And here comes Raven number 2. He was going to try to do a seeker missile, but he didn't get a chance to. And this mass Raven strategy, I don't know if he's going to be able to pull this off.
Well,
but maybe Shiva has. Maybe he's got something up his sleeve.
Well, like, he did send that Raven over there.
What's that?
He did send the Raven over there with no missile, no energy to do the missile, so...
Oh.
Yeah.
He was just a scout then.
What was it? Did you say something about a Shivan dragon? I think that's a different game.
No. I just took a look at the resources tab. He just tapped 5 colorless and 3 red mana, and he's about to get +1 on those attacks, I'm pretty sure.
I see. Yeah. Yes. That is a Shivan dragon, though, not Shiva Raven.
Hey, oh. I'm American. I say Shivan, okay?
Okay, that's fine. You see this... Raven getting chased by those Colossi. I don't know why the Colossi are chasing him. They can't attack him. Then basically they just stopped the Stalkers from being able to get it, and now they all just got lured into this mass siege tank and Thor situation, and wow.
It's a death trap. Oh, see, it's that fabled headbutt that the Colossi can do. They can headbutt air units, I swear to God. I've seen it
Seeker
before.
Missile? Oh, nothing there. They're just so slow.
There's been a, yeah, they are so slow. Maybe they should speed them up. Of course, then they might be OP. Oh no, no magic box action in there from Bones. He was unable to properly micro his Mutalisks. Those Thors were tearing him up. As these Thors roll out, those Mutalisks are pretty much helpless. So it looks like my team is going to have to regroup. They're really disappointing me. And it looks like all teams are going to be put into a situation here soon where they're going to have to pick up a second expand. So that's probably where the remainder of the action is going to revolve.
Yeah, no doubt. I just saw Bones do another Zap Brannigan push with the Zerglings. I love to see that. Truly a master of war. Or I definitely base all of my strategies off of his big book of war.
His big book? Is that what it's called?
Yeah, the Zap Brannigan big book of war.
Awesome. Of course it's a big book. Zap Brannigan wouldn't do it any other way.
Yes, it's true.
He's my hero. Let's see here. So Bones, yeah, he's just going mass muter at this point. He's going to have to transition. Bones has to transition. Those Thors are a hard counter. Okay, Jay Meister is getting smart, though. He does have a couple Immortals in his base that he's pumping out right now. Colossus are not going to be very effective. Mass Immortal right now, though, will be very, very super effective. A handful of Corruptors at this point would be good for Bones. Wouldn't you agree? Are Ravens armored? No, they're light, so he won't get that bonus damage.
No, but it'll be... It'll be worth picking up a couple, or maybe just sticking with those Mutalisks and just really microing them a little better. I'd like to see him, you know, flying them over here to these unguarded SCVs, or over here to these unguarded SCVs. But flying them towards this massive Ravens and Thors is also a good plan.
That is a good plan. If you're looking to win the Gozu tab, it is. Let's pull it up right now. Units lost. Right now, it looks like Bones is in a commanding position with 10,600 in units lost, over 201 units lost right now. He is in a commanding position. Jay Meister is hot on his heels. And as you know, ladies and gentlemen, if you win the Gozu tab, you get a JPEG of a trophy.
It is an amazing, amazing JPEG of a trophy. Custom made. No two are alike. And my team needs to step it up or step it down, depending on how you look at it, if they want to get in any action on that trophy.
They do. And it looks like Shiva is rolling out these Ravens right now. I'm at 2355. Let me know if I'm synced up with you, Danny. And this expansion here in the center of the map from Ares Drake, this thing's going to be hard to take down. He's got a massive Thors here and a bunch of missile turrets. And this is going to be up for a long time. Ain't no Mutalisk going to bust into that.
No, definitely not. Sieged up real good there. I'm just following these Ravens, though. What are we going to see? Yay, mass Ravens, he says. Okay, are we going to see a nice just point defense drone drop all into the mineral lines? The mineral lines are pretty much tapped out at this point, though, so it's about... I don't know, about 15 minutes too late in the game for this to be super effective.
It's going to be super effective for lols. All right, the Stalkers are getting free shots right now. Seeker missiles, shooting Seeker missiles one at a time at individual targets. That's not working out too well. Yes, put down some auto turrets. There you go, guys. There you go. Very slow on the micro here. He's got mass Ravens, but not using a mass strategy. Oh, no, here come the Mutalisks, Danny.
Oh, how about a point defense drone? Maybe. Oh, wow. Wow. Did you see those Mutalisks go right into that Seeker missile? That is amazing. 38 kills this Raven has. He is a commando.
It looks like did it damage his own men, though? Seeker missiles do damage your own units, correct?
Oh, yeah, it did. They're all tough, right? They're all pretty beat up right now. Just head back to base. I think SCVs can repair Ravens. I don't remember. Sounds like something they should be able to do.
They should definitely be able to do that. You don't see much Raven play, so we aren't as familiar with them as we would like to be. And it looks like the reinforcements are coming in here now. Well, Marines and Marauders in this base, I'm at 2625.
Yeah, so 2625. I'm actually at 2620. And the Marines are now tearing it up. They're taking out that wall-to-wall of pylons. Lots of point defense drones going down. Losing all of those Mutalisks was a terrible, terrible thing to happen to Bones.
Oh, it sure was. Oh, man. Jay Meister is in a bad position right now, and I don't know what Bones is going to be able to do to recover. He is building a number of Corruptors up here. He's going to try to do something. There are Seeker missiles getting in the game right now. These Corruptors are going to start racking up kills, but these Marines on the ground level are going to defend this up. Look at all these turrets on the ground. This is not a good situation.
Yes, that's no good. Those Corruptors are just going to get melted, no problem. Yeah, that's the end of those Corruptors. Marauders are just tearing up the buildings as they are apt to do. Oh, man, this... is a rough situation. We see that's a massive amount of Immortals from Jay Meister, though. I didn't even realize he had that many rolling out. Going to roll right into Ares Drake's base here, and here we go.
They aren't attacking. Danny, they aren't attacking. They're just running around and doing nothing. Look at this. Marvel. Marvel at the micro. They're like, I'm just a passing through, folks. No problems.
Oh, they stopped. They finally stopped and turned around. Wow. That was really impressive. They easily could have won this situation. And it likes... Had they come in microing properly, they easily could have won that. But as they lost about half of those immortals just from before firing a shot, that was amazing. Or was he going for the Gosu tab? Was that his overall plan?
Because he did. He just jumped in the lead, Danny. He's only ahead by 500 right now. It's neck on neck. Keep that unit's lost tab open right now because this is an epic battle.
Oh man, it's
and look
exciting.
At the top of the map. These Ravens are dropping now. Point defense drones out the yin yang at this expansion. Is this going to end the game?
I'm thinking that it might. We see Bones is leaving. Ares Drake is left. GG's all around. And the game ends. And Jay Meister with that last second. Walking my immortals through the enemy base without attacking. Picks up the Gosu tab with just about 700 more units, or exactly 700 more units, resources lost. Well played, sir. Well played.
Excellently played. I see that. I hear in the background a slow, sarcastic clap. I like that a lot. And one of the great features about this that I like is he jacked it from his ally. And he basically lost the game for his team and then jacked it from his ally. Actually, they were already doomed. All right, Jay Meister, ftwbroadcasting@gmail.com. Send us an email, and you get a JPEG of a trophy. So I want to thank everybody for watching this Trollcast, ladies and gentlemen. I know it's a ridiculous replay, and I want to thank Force Strategy Gaming for hosting us on his channel. We got plenty more Trollcasts on the way, folks. And subscribe to Force Strategy Gaming if you haven't already. Why? Because it's a great channel. My name's AWOL. Joining me, as always, is my boy Danny, and we'll see you in our next cast.